Amen. What a wonderful time in worship. I want to challenge you. Expect an encounter with the Lord every time you come into worship, whether that's at home, in your car, come on, or in church or in a small group. Expect the presence of the Lord to come. The Bible says he comes and inhabits the praises of his people. So he never not does it. He never just takes a break and go, you know what? It's a snowy day. I'm going to stay home in heaven. No, he always comes. He's attracted to your worship, to my worship. And so expect him to come. Amen. He loves that so much. You know, Jesus said that we are the light of the world and that we should not hide our light. We shouldn't hide it under things, but we should always make up our mind to shine our lights. Amen. And in the context of this whole month where we're talking about the spirit of poverty being broken off of our lives, it's not only for our sake, amen, but it's so that poverty would be broken off of a multitude of people around you as well. You and I are the light of the world. And I saw this amazing quote on Instagram last week. And it said that a candle doesn't get more dim when it lights another candle. Amen. But it just gets brighter. Rabbi Lappin taught us that increase, prosperity is not like a cake. If I get a bigger piece, you get a smaller piece. But prosperity and increase is just like a candle, that when you spread the light, the whole world gets brighter. Isn't that wonderful? I have found in the Word of God that there's two types of people. One who wants to just shine bright to be seen and wants to dim everyone else so they look brighter. And then there's other people who say, let's all light up. Come on, flame on. Let's all flame on, so that we actually bring some change to the world. Isn't that amazing? That's what Gideon did. He spread all of his fire amongst his 300 mighty men of valor. And what happened was they ran into the camp, come on, with those torches ablaze, and it sent confusion in the camp of the enemy. And the enemy was all about stealing, come on, and destroying and taking away all their possessions. And because light shone into the enemy's camp, what happened? Great victory for the children of Israel happened. And we have a Cain and an Abel, where Cain looked at Abel's bright light and was jealous and couldn't stand it, and he had to put it out. Amen. There's two types of people in the world. We don't want to be like Cain, who killed Abel because of his bright light. But we want to be people that are like Gideon, who say, you know what? More light is better. More light is better. Jesus is the Word of God. And the book of Psalms says that his word brings light and brings understanding. I want to challenge you to action this week. I want to ask you to spend time every morning in the presence of the Lord. Light is contagious. Will you hang out with dim people? Your light feels a little more dim. But unless you spend time with Jesus, come on, you're bright and you're fiery, full of his light. But light is also contagious, and hang out with people this week. Come on, spend some time on purpose with people who have light in their lives, maybe who are further ahead of you in prosperity, in positive thinking. Come on, in their faith, further in their faith, further in their spreading and boldness of spreading their light. Amen. Do it on purpose this week. I love this scripture. It says in Isaiah 9 verse 2, the people who walk in darkness will see a great light. For those who live in a land of deep darkness, a light will shine. That was a prophecy by the prophet Isaiah, that even though the whole world is steeped in darkness, you know, the world has no light of its own. Unless you work at a Christian company, your company has no light. Your company only has darkness. But when you come in there, you're the light. Come on. Your school, your family may be full of darkness and has no light in itself. But when you show up, because you are the follower of Jesus Christ, because you spend time with him, because you're in his word, you're going to cause a bright flame to shine in that place. Amen. So Father, I pray that boldness would come upon all of us and those watching online right now and those in this room. I pray, Father, that the boldness would come to draw near to you first of all. That all week, Lord, we will not just go through the motions, but we will make appointments with you throughout the day. Maybe in the morning, maybe in the evening, maybe several times throughout the day. But to spend time with you until we have seen you face to face. Until we feel your presence. Until we have a revelation in your word by your spirit. And I ask God for boldness upon all of us this week. That we would shine brighter. That we would actually share the light that we have. That we will pop our little bubble and ask people interesting questions. Lord, to get into their lives, just like Jesus was always asking questions. We ask, Father, that you give us that mindset this week. To ask lots of questions to people. To get them to think about life and their purpose. Why they're here. Why they are in Washington. Why they are at their job. What they are hoping for the future. What they are leaving behind and what they're reaching for. And let us have words that bring light and understanding to them, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus.